Hi everyone, we're making lemon pasta with garlic and basil. Now this is a great, quick, easy recipe to make anytime. It takes just a few minutes to put together and you have a nice dinner. You can also add some grilled shrimp to this or chicken if you want, but it's definitely a standalone pasta dish that you're gonna love. And I'm also using Banza pasta just to lower the carbs a bit, add a little more protein and a little more fiber. So I'm Rockin' Robin and I'm gonna show you how to make it right after this. All right, let's start off with our chef joke. And I have another one for you a little bit later, so stay tuned for that. All right, so how did the pasta chef get locked out of his house? He came home with gnocchi. Let me go over our ingredients so we can get started. So first up is, like I mentioned earlier, we're using Banza pasta. We're using the spaghetti version that they have. It's a chickpea pasta, in case you're not familiar. After that, we're gonna need some garlic. That's our garlic in that. I just chopped this up nice and fresh, and you want it nice and fine. I like it minced. I'm using some half and half. Now, I've had this question before. Some people don't know what half and half is. Half and half is half milk and half cream. It's not quite so rich as heavy cream, so we'll be using that. I'm using some pecorino romano here. I just grated up some, and you can use parmesan if you like. We're gonna be adding some asparagus to this, so you just wanna trim off your asparagus, get the stiff end off, the fibrous end, so it's, you know, not difficult to chew, and you just trim them up. Then I wanna cut these up into bite-sized pieces, and we're gonna be sauteing these a little bit later. I'll be using a couple of organic lemons. We're gonna be using the zest from this and the juice. We'll need a couple of tablespoons of, I have pastured butter here. This is Kerrygold butter. We'll be using some fresh basil, which we have right here, and some fresh Italian parsley. So with the basil, we're just gonna stack the leaves here. It makes it easier to roll and then slice. And I'll just continue that until I get all this chopped up. So with the parsley, what you want to do is just take your knife and sort of shave off the leaves so you minimize the stems. And then you just chop it up. And we'll need some salt and olive oil. Time for chef joke number two. What happens when life gives you pickles instead of lemons? You deal with it. So I want to recommend that you get everything set up and ready to go. Like I've got it here. I've got everything cut up, shredded, you know, prepared and measured before I start this recipe because it cooks up really quickly. Now here's my pan where we're going to be cooking everything. And right back here, I have some water boiling, getting it ready for my pasta so I can cook it. So I've got my pan here. I'm going to start out with medium high heat and I'm going to add some olive oil to the pan. And to that, I'm gonna add the asparagus because it's gonna take just a couple of minutes. We're gonna cook this for about 3, maybe 4 minutes, no more. Just wanted to get it a little tender. So the pasta takes about 8 to 10 minutes. That's what it says on the package. I wanna cook it just a little al dente, so I'm gonna go for 7 minutes. And since all of this isn't gonna take very long, I'm gonna start that now. So I just dumped the pasta into some salted water and we're gonna let that cook. Okay, I'm gonna turn the temperature down a little bit on the asparagus because it's taken off pretty good. Asparagus has been cooking 3 minutes. You can always test it with a fork and see how it is, if it's real crisp or if it's just about right and ready to go, because it's gonna cook a little bit more as we continue on. Yeah, that's feeling pretty good. It's somewhere between 3 and 4 minutes, depending on how thick your asparagus is. Obviously, thicker is gonna take longer. All right, I'm gonna add the butter to the pan now. Let's get that in there. Once that butter melts, we're gonna add our garlic. This is going to mellow out the flavor and just make this taste amazing. Now I'm on medium-low heat and now I'm starting to smell that garlic. Ooh, that smells so good. Give that 1 minute. We don't need to saute this very long, that garlic. We don't want it to burn. I'm gonna turn the heat to low on the asparagus and we're gonna start adding our other ingredients. So here's the cream. Here's our lemon juice. Our lemon zest. Mix it all around. And I want to bring this up to a simmer. I'm going to add a pinch of salt to this. Maybe about a half a teaspoon or so. You can always taste it. We'll taste it a little bit later and see how it's doing. You can see now this has come to a simmer, so I'm going to turn it down again and I'm going to add the basil and the cheese. And that's going to help to thicken up the sauce as well as that cream. Now you can give it a taste and you can adjust for salt if you wish. I'm going to add just another pinch of salt to that. And it is now pretty much ready to accept the noodles, but we're just waiting on those to finish up, which will be in a, well, right now. So I'm testing the pasta and it is just a touch al dente, so it's perfect. So I drained and rinsed the noodles as per directions, and now I'm going to add them to the sauce. All right, you want to take some tongs, and then we're just going to drop this pasta right into the pan. And that sauce is going to absorb right into all that pasta. Now you take your tongs and you just give it the best stir you can. Just want to mix all that beautiful sauce into this. Now let me serve some of this up. And we'll garnish with a little bit of fresh parsley. And here we go. So delicious, nice lemony flavor. That garlic comes through nice and subtle, very delicious. So if you'd like to add some garlic bread to this recipe, you know, it would be great. I have a recipe for you. You gotta try it out. It's very popular. I'll leave a link right over here for my ultimate garlic bread with roasted garlic. So delicious. You gotta try it. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Smash the like button for me and leave me a comment. We'll see you next time.